Salt Lake Potash is Tony Swiericzuk. Tony, welcome back. Good to see you.
Thanks for having me again, Andrew.
Give us a snapshot, Tony. I know approaching quite a critical point as far as Lake Ways development. Where are we?
Yeah, we've been bolting along there at Lake Way at Wiluna, and very, very proud to say that progress on the plant is now over 95% complete on an earned basis, and we are basically commissioning for us is imminent, and that's all the works that are associated with the pre-load commissioning before we actually introduce the harvest salts, which will be a little bit later on in quarter two. But absolutely fantastic progress has been made by the team up there in the last couple of months.
So what's the majority of remaining work? What's left to be done?
Yeah, look, over the last few months, the team have been tasked with sort of pulling 54 kilometres of cable through the plant. There's about 800 tonne of structural steel has gone up. That's all complete now. So concreting's complete, structural steel's complete. Cable pulling is about 85% complete, so nearing that sort of 46, 47 kilometres of cable being pulled. Piping, there's 10 kilometres of piping has to go into this plant that sits alongside 100 pumps. At the moment, the sole focus, if you like, is on basically instrumentation completion and the completion of piping in the plant.
And so on track, you reckon, for first SOP production and sales in the June quarter?
Yeah, look, we started to energise the front end of the plant over the weekend, yesterday, in fact, and we start bump testing conveyors on the front end today, and this Thursday I'm up on site with a small team, and we'll be commissioning what we call the front end with salts, and basically that's the feed hopper, the first two conveyors, the surge bin, the sizer, and then into the first attritioning tank in the plant. That's all happening this Thursday up on site, so a fantastic flag waving event that'll be happening up there, and then heads down, ears pinned back, and the commissioning continues basically for the next 8 weeks, and as we walk into quarter two, and then start producing premium SOP.
And as far as the senior debt structure, that's all finalised and in place now, is it?
Yeah, look, that's a big tick. Taurus is the lead manager alongside Clean Energy that's also there, have managed to attract Sequoia, a UK-based fund, and Commonwealth Bank of Australia, CBA, have come in as well, which I think speaks volumes, to the reputation of the project. And I mean, those two new parties or new banks have done their own due diligence on this and elected to come in. And that's now syndicated with four funders, our senior debt facility of a US $138 million.
Remind us, how much are you initially looking to produce here?
Look, when we get up to nameplate capacity, and that's basically going to be in the fiscal year or the end of fiscal year 22 or calendar year quarter two, 22. That's when we get up to the nameplate capacity of 245,000 tonnes per annum.
And you are looking at a fairly green approach when it comes to production, aren't you?
A very green approach, Andrew. I mean, that's we're getting a lot of interest from ESG funds out there. It's the largest, source of our energy that is used in this production process is the sun. It's the solar evaporation process that basically produces the harvest salts that go into a very simple, process plant that then produces fertilizer to feed people. So it's got a great green thematic behind it.
Might seem a bit of an obvious question here, but all approvals, all the green lights are in place to get into production now, I'm assuming, are they?
Yeah, that's a common question I get asked. Our final approvals left the EPA, the Environmental Protection Agency in WA, and made its way to the Environment Minister's office here in early February. The appeals period, the 14-day appeals period for public review closed on the 15th of February, and we had no appeals. And that now is just working its way through with final signatures. We expect that in the latter parts of this month, March.
Is this not something that would typically be done a bit earlier on in the process?
Yeah, look, that's a unique nature, I suppose, and how we differentiate ourselves in this project and this program. We staged the approvals, we staged the funding, and we to support a staged construction, and that's let us just move ahead so fast over the last 2 years instead of waiting around 4 to 5 years or even longer, which would be typical. We've managed to get this up and over the line from a cold start in about 2 years and 3 months. So I'm very proud to have led that, and I think it's quite unique, and I think other companies can learn from it.
So you're on the home straight now, Tony. How are you feeling?
honestly, tired, but look, very pleased, very proud. You know, the team's done a great effort. You know, as people would say, we're coming to the pointy end now. So proof's in the pudding. We've really got to push this thing over the line. And, you know, with a plant that's sort of north of 95% complete, total project north of 85% complete, it's that we're running down that home straight, the last 100 metres in the marathon. And that's the hardest straight to run on.
Good to catch up. Tony, thanks very much.
Pleasure. Thanks, Andrew.